CompTIA ITF Plus Complete Training Course. Exam Objective 2.8, given a scenario, install, configure and secure a basic wireless network. Interference and attenuation. We will start this video off with the topic of interference and save attenuation for the end. With that said, there are two types of interference that we will cover. The first of which is electromagnetic interference. Electromagnetic interference, or EMI, is a disturbance or noise caused by electromagnetic signals that interfere with the proper functioning of electronic devices. Electromagnetic interference happens when electromagnetic waves from one electronic device interferes with the signals or operations of another nearby electronic device. These waves can be produced by various sources, such as Wi-Fi signals, cell phones, power lines, and even microwave ovens. So how does this topic fit in with our current exam objective covering wireless networks? Because, when electromagnetic interference becomes too great, it can lead to a disruption in wireless communications and cause weaker than expected broadcast signals. So what should you do if you have a problem? Ensure that EMI sources are either removed or at least kept to a minimum if you want reliable wireless communications. Next up, we have another related topic. Signal-to-noise ratio, or SNR for short. Signal-to-noise ratio is a measure used to describe the quality of a signal by comparing a desired signal against any background noise or interference that is present. Imagine you're having a conversation with someone in a noisy room. The desired signal is your voice, and the noise is the background chatter and other sounds in the room. The clarity of your conversation depends on how loudly you speak compared to the noise level. If your voice is much louder than the noise, the other person can hear you clearly, and the conversation is successful. This is a high signal-to-noise ratio. Speak too softly, and your voice will not be distinguishable from the crowd. This is a low signal-to-noise ratio. In the context of technology, a signal-to-noise ratio works similarly. It compares the strength of the desired signal, like a Wi-Fi signal, to the background noise, such as electromagnetic interference. A high signal-to-noise ratio means the desired signal is strong compared to the noise, resulting in clear and reliable communication or data transmission. On the other hand, a low signal-to-noise ratio means the signal is weaker, making it more challenging to distinguish the signal from the noise, leading to slow or unstable communications. Now that you understand the impact of EMI and the importance of maintaining a high signal-to-noise ratio, let's now explore the second type of interference, physical obstructions. Yes, a physical obstruction can also introduce signal interference. For instance, any solid structure, such as a brick wall, can cause interference and weaken a wireless communication signal that has to pass through it. And just like EMI, this form of physical interference can also lead to slow or unstable communications. The frequency of a wireless signal will also have an effect on how much interference is experienced as a result of a physical obstruction. To keep this brief and on topic, the 2.4 GHz band will experience less physical interference than the 5 GHz band in most cases. You're almost there. We just need to cover one more property that can result in a weakened communication signal. And that is attenuation. Attenuation is the loss of signal strength as the transmission distance increases. Or alternatively, you can say, a signal decreases in strength the further it travels from its origination point or source. To grasp this concept, imagine the light coming from a flashlight getting dimmer as you move further away from its source. Similarly, as a signal travels over distance, it becomes weaker. The farther the signal travels, the more it attenuates. Okay, great job with this video. You should now understand how EMI, physical interference, and signal attenuation can collectively weaken a communication signal and lower the signal-to-noise ratio. If not, try watching this video again. Thank you for watching. Subscribe for more great content.